play this one solo. It's very much a solo piece. So because the lyrics are what drive the song rather than the music. And it tells the true story. I'm sure we're all, you DIY veterans, will know the story of Lance Sergeant Joseph William Stones from Crook, who joined, who was too short to join in 1914. He was only 5'2", so he was refused the opportunity to join. But then in 1915, when the age restriction was lowered, he was able to join the Bantam Regiment, one of the Bantam Regiments. And despite being decorated twice for bravery during the First World War, under dubious circumstances, he was deemed to have cast his weapon aside and was subsequently trapped, court-martialed and sentenced to die, shot at dawn as a coward. So this is his story, the Ballad of Lance Sergeant William Stones. Joseph William Stones, the lifeblood of Durham, ran deep in my bones. A miner from Crook, standing all of 5'2", deemed too short to fight, fit only to hew. But I then joined the Bantams in 1915, a volunteer in the Durham Light Infantry. A Lance Sergeant decorated for extreme bravery, shot at dawn as a coward in 1917. The terror of the guns I bravely defied, the horrors of the trenches I somehow survived, only to face death by a different name, stripped of all honour, butchered in shame. Though my superiors cast glowing testimonies, I was guilty as charged by court-martial decreed. British Army justice, so cruel and so vague, the brutal tyranny of bloody butcher hate. As the sentence was passed, my stomach turned weak, but they'd given me no permission to speak. I simply stood there as my glazed eyes gazed through the blank faces of my judges who no mercy knew. Ambulance drivers, head hung in shame, driving us to our doom at the dawn of the day. Blindfolded, manacled, two Lance Sergeants and I, each tied to a post, sentenced to die. The farmyard near Arras, the last place I saw, so quiet and peaceful amid the horrors of war. 36 bullets and 36 men, 12 for each prisoner, how could they fail then? Yet not one of those men fired a shot that ran true, afraid of guilt's burden, what else could they do? As the final squad officer, his pistol he drew, and our brains and our souls to eternity blew. Yet not one of those men, braver men I never have met, were the words of the chaplain who wrote with regret how he prayed with us before that fatal dawn, and how we were murdered on that terrible morn. There were no birds to sing, nor the bugle to play, the last post as they carried our bodies away. Just a sad mournful breeze to usher our souls to the great unknown, when no guilty bell tolls. Oh Lizzie, my Lizzie, you were victimized too. There's no pensions for cowards, widows, they told you, as they left you to rot and go quietly insane, along with your memories, your loss and your pain. 305 of us were damned just like me to walk the ghost road through eternity. These doomed youth an anthem and peace were denied, unjustly condemned, shot by their own side. My name was erased from the family line to be rediscovered and restored after time. Now 80 years after I was slaughtered in shame, the local memorial at last bears my name. A royal pardon was granted at last, 90 years after the sentence was passed. And even though the conviction remains, I suppose we must welcome any small gains. Now they call it post-traumatic stress syndrome, a cause that in my time was simply unknown. Though no one else will now suffer like me from the evil of war, we will never be free.
Thank you.